those who cling to worthless idols forfeit the grace that could be theirs. Those who cling to worthless idols forfeit the grace that could be theirs. The title of our message today is Seizing the Grace We Need. See, if you can forfeit the grace that could have been yours by clinging to worthless idols, by implication, what Jonah is saying is if you do the opposite, you cleave or return to the Lord, that God will release the grace that he originally intended. Does that make any sense? So some of us in this major time of transition are in a place where we need grace and mercy. How many say I'm somebody that needs grace? Mercy is the answer for what you've done wrong. Mercy is what we need when we have transgressed. Mercy is what we can receive from God. Grace is what we need when we're weak. Grace is what we need to align us. How many know that Nineveh, the name Nineveh really means house of fish? It's a big city. Nineveh is located in the ancient territory of Assyria. How many heard that Judah and Israel were taken into captivity by two different cultures, two different national groups? One was Babylon. How many heard of Babylonian captivity? And Assyria. And the Assyrians lived, guess where? In Assyria. That's pretty good. Assyria is modern-day Iraq. So where we are is northern Iraq. The city of Nineveh is right across the river from this place, Mosul, that has been in the news recently. How many have heard that ISIS burned an 1,800-year-old church in Mosul? How many heard that? And that there were people that were told, you either repent or get out of here, to become Islamic, or you get out of here, or you'll get killed right there in Mosul. And the city Nineveh is one of the largest continuously inhabited cities in that part of the world. And it was huge during the time of Jonah. They had about 120,000 people there, and the circumference of the city, I'm getting all of this from the book of Jonah. If you read those four chapters, you'll find that what I'm stating is facts in the written scripture. The city was about a 60-mile circumference in terms of you're walking by foot. It was spread out that far. In other words, if you take the D.C. metro area, from about Columbia down to Manassas, walk around it, it may have been just a little bit smaller than that, but it was huge, and it had the implication of being, for its day, a mega metro area. Very interesting place, Nineveh. We find that it was mentioned first in Genesis chapter 10, but to our real pressing point, we have several things that we see are opportunities for us to grab hold of truth in this particular passage. Verse 8 again says, those who cling to worthless idols do what? What's the word? It's interesting that if we think about what the story of Jonah was all about, it looks something like this, and this may be even written in your Bible. If I look at the headings in the chapters in my Bible, I can see right over chapter 1 in my Bible, it says, Jonah runs away. Anybody see that? Something like that. Jonah was called by God to deliver a message to the people of Nineveh. He was not delighted in doing this because, again, I don't want to get too historic on you, but as we look back at the story Hezekiah, how many were here when we talked about Hezekiah? And when we talked about Hezekiah, King Sennacherib of the Assyrians, who stood outside the walls of Jerusalem, threatened to tear down everything, wipe out everybody, was an Assyrian. They were cruel people. They had very unusual practices. It would make the ISIS people look like kindergartners.